Hello and welcome, Grafana Champion is here. My name is Daria Volkova and this channel helps utilize Grafana to its full potential. In this video, I would like to discuss Grafana's customization. We covered this topic in the past, but it is time for refresher since the major new release 11.0 has been implemented. Are you excited to explore the possibilities of customization in Grafana 11? Let's go! And I will get right into the topic. So what can you customize in Grafana? This is a login page that everybody sees right after the installation. Here you can change the big image in the center of the page. It is the same picture that is shown in Grafana in the top left corner. The welcome text. In my example, I replace welcome to Grafana with business suite for Grafana. The icon on the browser tab. I put the rocket here. The application name is displayed next to it and business suite in my example. Links in the footer. In my instance, I remove them all and have free space here. Optionally, you can configure Grafana to skip the login page altogether. It is mainly needed for public dashboards and anonymous access. Alright, once a user passes the login page, you can direct them to your home dashboard. When the home dashboard is specified, it opens after login and also when a user clicks on the home link here. The home dashboard is displayed without a path. The rest of the dashboards have a path, but your home dashboard looks like a starting point. Grafana has a light and dark theme, which can be altered in the profile, preferences, interface theme. I prefer a light theme. You can configure the light theme for new users changing configuration. The next feature is this mega menu that appears on the left-hand side. You can remove any elements or sub-elements or add a new menu. For instance, if your application focuses on a data visualization feature, it might not require the alerts and explore components. You can remove the corresponding menus to avoid user confusion about what they are for. In our release.volkovlabs.io project, we added a new menu called Business Suite. It opens a new page with all the plugins created and maintained by Volkovlabs. The project is open to public and you can check it out anytime. I'm moving to the right-hand side of the screen. This news icon can be hidden if you believe it's unnecessary. The help menu, which appears when a user clicks on the question mark in the circle, can be altered. For instance, I included our application name and our latest version here. Optionally, you can remove all unrelated menu elements if needed. What do you think so far? Ready to move to the next possibility? When users add a new panel, on the right-hand side, they have a list of all native and installed community panels. You can indeed control what is available for this selection. For instance, if you remove the alerting part from your application, consider removing the alert list and annotation list visualizations. That saves screen space and helps your users choose better. Similar to limiting the available visualization panel selection, you can simplify selecting a new data source. Here in the connection menu, then the Add Data Source button, by default, Grafana offers a huge variety of data sources, which is unbelievably awesome, especially for someone learning about Grafana as a platform. However, for a targeted audience, it might be better to keep the selection small and only include data sources relevant to your requirements. In my example, I have 8 data sources for the users to choose from. Customization can be helpful in so many ways. If you guys have anything to add to what I mentioned in this video, please tell us what else can be customized in Grafana. We would love to hear from you. The last important note is that the customization steps look different for Grafana installed in a Docker container and Grafana installed directly on Windows or Mac. Everything I mentioned is possible for both types of installation. As for the actual customization commands, please take a look at this article on our company blog, volkovlabs.io/blog. I described everything in detail with warnings and pitfalls. This is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.